Hey, welcome to the second episode in my series, Using an iPad Pro as a Laptop. Today, we're going to be using Luma Fusion to do some video editing on the 12.9-inch 2017 iPad Pro, and we're going to be doing that by doing a hands-on right on the iPad Pro itself. So here we go. All right, so here we are back on the iPad Pro, and I'm going to launch up Luma Fusion. So again, Luma Fusion is pretty much a professional-grade video editing software for the iPad. It's an iPad kind of exclusive, and really for the iPad Pro. It's available for iPhone and the regular iPad, but it's not going to work as well as it will on the Pro here. So as you can see, you can get three tracks of video, three tracks of audio, and you can layer them on top of each other. And you can do things like I have some video on this top layer and then I blurred the background. You can have multiple layers. I could add more audio tracks underneath. And this is just a project that I did for a test. So let's go ahead and start a new project. And I'm just going to do a basic overview. This is not going to be real in-depth, but just show you some of the things you can do with it. So let's go ahead and hit the plus to do a new video. You can select the name, the frame rate, and the aspect ratio. In this case, I know my source footage is 24 frames per second, and I'm just gonna do just a test project. All right, that's fine. And create the project. So now we have a blank project. So to add media into your project, you're gonna go into your moments, and then let's go to, let's see, October 23rd is when I loaded some of this footage in here, and let's tap on one of these. It'll show you kind of a preview in this preview window here, and then you can scrub through the video, or you can play and get to a point where you want to stop. Let's go to here, you know, get some video of me talking. So let's say we want to start the video right here. So I'm going to set the endpoint there, and then you can drag over, and you can also set an out point, and then just bring it down into your timeline by hitting this button right here. So one thing that I really like here is the way it shows the waveforms here, and then as you zoom in, it adjusts that, so you can really dial in to exactly where you want to edit against the audio, and then you can zoom back out just with a pinch gesture, as you know, would expect on an iOS device. So let's grab another clip now. So let's say I choose this one and I want to use the whole thing. So again, I can use the button there to put it in wherever the cursor is, but I can also tap and hold a little bit and then bring it down and just drop it on my timeline right there. And then that uses the clip and puts it right next to the other one. So right now, there's just a basic jump cut. So let's say I don't want a jump cut and I want to put in some transitions. We can go up into here, go to transitions, and it has all these built-in transitions and gives you a kind of a little preview of what's going to happen with that transition. Now, let's say I decide, you know, a horizontal wipe would look good right here. So I can just, again, tap and hold for a second, drag it right there, it puts it right on, and it'll render it in real time. And again, guys, this is full 4K video at 24 frames per second that I took right off my camera. I haven't transcoded this. This isn't a proxy or anything. It's playing it all real time, doing the real time transitions, and you know, it's not stuttering at all. You can do other things. You can add audio into additional tracks. So we can go back out here, and let's get to our royalty-free music. So this royalty-free music is included with LumaFusion. And let's just say I want this news background audio for whatever reason. We can just tap that, drag it down here, and put it in the timeline. I can just move it back to the beginning if I want to start when the video starts. So now we have that audio playing in the background. And the same thing with the video. If I want to add another video clip in here, I can go back to my photos and let's say for whatever reason I want this controller to show up over part of my yap in here. So we can do that and
adjustable to different angles.
So now we have that. And let's say I don't want this video to take up the whole screen. We can double tap on this to bring you into some advanced settings. And you can set all different things here, like the sound. If I want to mute the volume on this clip because it was just B-roll, I can hit sound and bring the volume all the way down. And then if I want to adjust the size, I can tap on frame and fit down in the corner there. And then I can adjust the size. I can adjust the position. So if I say I want it just to be up in that corner, I can put it up in the corner. You can even stretch it out, change the ratio there. And then again, it's all in real time. So then we can go back and play it.
To different,
and now we can see it's exactly where I put it. So some other of the advanced things that you can do are you can go into the color and effects and put all these different effects. Here's some color effects and just all these different presets. You can do vignettes, blur. So you can come in here and do all kinds of different artistic overlays, like a reflection, a mirror, all kinds of stuff. You can put it on and then change the radius and, you know, all these different criteria for the effect. And then if you decide you don't like it, you can just hit the trash and get rid of it and go back. Same as for audio, you can go in here to some advanced audio settings and set up all kinds of filters and change the volume of your audio. And then you can also, if you want to use the audio as a separate track, if you want the audio separate from your video, you can just triple tap on here and it splits out that audio, and now you have control over that audio separate from the video track. So guys, I won't go into the other effects and transitions. It's extremely full-featured software that I could easily use as my mobile editing software, with one exception, and that is the music. So you have, you know, the royalty-free music that it includes, and it's great. I mean, they have some great selections in here. But if you want to use your own music, you have to preload it on your iPad before you travel, because you can't just go out to SoundCloud or something like that and download directly to the iPad like you would with a laptop or a PC. You have to have it preloaded on here or purchase it through iTunes or some other way. You can't just download something from a website like I normally would. That's part of my workflow. So that is a major flaw, and that's one thing that's keeping me from using the iPad Pro as a mobile editing device, because I don't want to have to preload the music. If I'm going to do that, I'm probably going to be using my laptop anyway. I'm not going to download it on one machine and then transfer it over to another machine to do editing. I'm going to do it on whatever machine I have the media on. All right, so overall, I would have to say this was actually a really good experience. LumaFusion is a fantastic piece of software. They're not paying me for this or anything. This is just my opinion. I absolutely love the software. I don't have a problem with it at all. The problem I have is with the device itself and kind of the limitations of iOS. This is a major deal breaker for me. It may not be for you. It may not be a big deal, but having to preload the music onto the device. My workflow is that I start my editing, and then based on the feel of the editing, I'll go out and grab some music that kind of fits the type of video that I'm doing. I'm not necessarily going to know ahead of time what music I want to use for the video. And the fact that I can't just go out to SoundCloud or some other area and get some royalty-free music and load it on the iPad and use it in my video, that's a deal breaker for me. It kind of breaks my workflow. The software itself is fantastic. Actually, the device is fantastic. For me, the limitation is with the OS. As always, thanks so much for watching. Please hit that subscribe button if you want to see the next episode in this series. I'm also going to be doing some new review and tutorial videos coming up. And come see me on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. I love meeting new people on there and chatting with them. And I will see you in the next video.